feel ya. I feel ya. Let the horns play. Come on.
Church announcements for the week of April 14, 2024. Union Hill Cumberland Presbyterian Church in America is having their Mothers, Elders, and Deacon Board's annual candlelight march on today at 2 p.m. Elder Phil Ford, pastor of New Greater St. John PB Church, will be the guest speaker. The Christian Education Committee is sponsoring a financial workshop on April 27, 2024, at 10 a.m. Please save the date and join us as we make sense of your sense, tithing, savings, investing. More information to come. Save the date. Brown Girls Retreat, July 19th to 20th, 2024. Theme, Stay Focused on God. Psalms 119 verse 105. More information will follow later. Chaplain, Colonel Retired, David Lockhart, a son of Blackburn CPCA, published Faith for the Journey, a 60-day devotional featuring Elder Tom Erskine in one of the devotional titles, A Balm in Gilead. You can purchase a copy today from Elder Maxine Lockhart or order one from Amazon. I appreciate your support. Our very own Tyler Hatton will be in a production of Mean Girls at Bob Jones High School. CYF will go and show support on Saturday, April 20th at 2 p.m. If you would like to join us, the van is available to those who want to ride or follow. However, we need to know so that we can prepare. You may contact Sister Kennedy Petty to sign up or if you have any further questions. There are other showtimes and ticket prices are also listed on the school's website if you cannot join us on that day. Wishing JC Washington good luck as she travels to Washington and Virginia to compete with her school as the AAA Clowns. JC, we are so proud of you and good luck, we love you. To all individuals on the kitchen committee, we will have a short meeting on the third Sunday in April, April 21st, immediately following morning worship service. We will be discussing the men's appreciation dinner. This meeting is also open to anyone who would like to join the kitchen committee. Thank you, Jessica Washington. Our mid-year organizational meeting is Monday, April 22nd at 6:30 p.m. at the church. All committee chairs and co-chairs are asked to be in attendance. Members in need of a ride to worship on Sunday mornings, contact Elder Barbara Hall no later than Friday evening at 6 p.m. Join us each Wednesday for midday Bible study at 11:30 a.m. at the church and our evening Bible study at 6:45 p.m. To join evenings, call 1-339-209-4599 or log on to freeconferencecall.com Blackburn Chapel Church 7 via the internet. Please submit all announcements to bcbulletin@yahoo.com no later than each Wednesday evening by 8 p.m. and all pre-recorded audio of announcements must be submitted to blackburnchapelchurch@outlook.com no later than each Friday by 6 p.m. Thought for the week. If you only pray when you're in trouble, you're in trouble. 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 17. Thank you and have a blessed week.
Good morning, Blackburn Chapel, and those who are with us today and watching on our live stream worship service. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Our scripture reading will be coming from Isaiah chapter 41 and verse 10, King James Version. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. I will help thee. I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Let us pray. O Lord, hear our prayers as we come to you this morning. We give you thanks for what you have done and count it all joy for what you are about to do. I pray for my mother and my father and family. We pray for the Pastor Snodgrass and his family. We pray for Blackburn Chapel Church family. Bless our youth, our schools, and our teachers. Lord, thank you for being our protector. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Hello? Oh, okay. Dear God, thank you for such a beautiful morning. Thank you for the gift of life, as well as your mercy and goodness. Continue to bless us as we begin our journey in life. I pray that you will guide us and make our steps fruitful. If we are wrong, right us. If we are lost, guide us. If we start to give up, keep us going. Lead us in the light and love. And in your loving name, I pray, amen.
Thank you.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Blackburn Chapel. The choir said, can I get a witness? Can we get a witness today? Somebody ought to cry, holy, holy. Because the God we serve is mighty, mighty. You can worship him in the morning, morning. I tell you, I just entered into his gates today. And it's just a default of the redeemed to enter into his gates with thanksgiving. And it's a default to enter into his courts with praise. We come with a thanksgiving because the Lord is good. I don't know if he woke you up this morning, but he woke me up this morning. And he started me on my right way with a sound mind and with a praise on my lips. We are grateful to be in the presence of God today. We are grateful to be in the house of the Lord today. We have come with joy on our hearts because it is yet another week that the Lord has kept us. I have been kept. I don't know about you, but I've been kept by the mercies of God. So I'm welcoming. I come in. I want to come to worship God. And those of you that may be visiting or those that you might be watching us online, we want you to feel welcome to worship God. Do not let anything hold you back from worshiping your God. Can I get a witness? You might not like a noisy church, but sometimes we become that noisy church because we can't help but to think about his goodness. And when we think about God's goodness, and when we think about what he has done, not what he's done for you, but what he has done for me, my soul cries out. Can I get a witness? Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Oh, my soul cries out. Praise God for saving me. We want to welcome you this morning because you could have been any place else, but you honor us with your presence online and in the room. And we want to know if there's anybody in here that is not a member or who is a visitor or a guest. We want you to stand up so we can acknowledge you in the name of the Lord, please. Any guests, amen. Put your hands together. Bless the name of our God. Bless the name of our God. Please greet them. Engage with them. We thank you for joining us today because the God we serve is true and living. And if you want to come to a living church, you found the right place because the God that lives is living inside of me. Lord, have mercy. I don't know if you were Lazarus, but you're going to be alive today. I don't know if you were a Syrophoenician woman, but you're going to get some more than crumbs today. If you come into the house of the Lord, if you're hungry and thirsting after righteousness, I will promise you, according to the word of God, that you'll end up being filled. God bless you in Jesus' name. Before she comes, I want to just announce, Asia gave this to me. I'm sorry, Asia. I messed up. The Blackburn Chapel invites you to walk for purpose. The multiple sclerosis walk is going to start at 9 a.m. on Saturday, April 27th at 8:45. Well, 8:45, be there. It starts at 9. It'll be at Legacy Park, 6001 Cecil Fane Drive. In Huntsville, Alabama, 6001 Cecil Fane Drive in Huntsville, Alabama. Please come out and support that effort. Thank you, Asia.
It is now time for our giving. You may give online with our Givelify, mail, or bring your tithes to the church. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. Matthew 6:21. Let us pray. Lord God, you love this world so much that you gave your one and only Son that we might be called your children too. Lord, help us to live in gladness and grace each day. Let us have hearts of thankfulness for your sacrifice. Let us have eyes that look upon your grace and rejoice in our salvation. Lord, help us to walk in that mighty grace and tell your good news to the world. All for your glory, we do pray. Amen.
Amen. Good morning. How many of you know that your life is in God's hand? Amen. Oh, what a mighty good hand to be in. You know, some said Michael Jordan, you know, a ball in his hand was worth a lot. Oh, but to be in God's hand, can't put a dollar on it, because he's good and he's wonderful and greatly to be praised this morning. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we come this morning, Lord, just as humble as I know how. Lord, I come thanking you for your mercy, your loving kindness, your goodness towards me. Lord, I come today, Lord God, realizing, Lord, that you sit high and you look low. Lord, you know all about us. Lord God, because you made us. Now, Heavenly Father, we come this morning to lift you high, to glorify and magnify your name. Oh God, you're so worthy to be praised. Now, Heavenly Father, as I come, Lord, Lord, I come asking for your strength. Lord, I come this morning leaning and depending upon you. Lord, you said we could ask, trust you, and believe, and it shall be done unto us. Now, Lord, I pray, God, that you would decrease Virginia and increase your Holy Spirit in me the more. God, I thank you for another opportunity. I praise your holy name, for it's in the name of Jesus, and for his sake I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Good morning to those in the sanctuary and to those that are online. I count it another blessing to be in the house of the Lord once again. And I give honor to my beloved Pastor Snodgrass for asking me to stand while he can get some rest. So I ask that you don't look at Virginia. Look at the cross this morning. Look at the cross. Don't look at me. I'm just a vessel for the Lord. To the elders and the mothers, deacons, everybody that's here, I thank you for being here today and allowing me this an opportunity to stand. I don't bring to you nothing new today. I just bring to you the word of God that has strengthened and blessed me so. So if you will, turn with me to Isaiah, the 40th chapter, verse 31. You hear it all the time, but we're going to talk about it today because God gave it to me to bring to you. Verse 31 of Isaiah, the 40th chapter, it says, "But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew thy strength." Anybody need to be renewed today?
Amen.
He'll renew you over and over and over again. "They shall mount up with wings as an eagle. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint." See, on this journey that we have, we get weak sometimes. We get weary sometimes. Sometimes we're running because we got so much energy. Other times we want to quit, but don't give up. So today I chose for a subject, the waiting period. The waiting period. Now we all have waiting periods. whether we're in the grocery store, sometimes we have to wait in line. And when we wait in the line, what are we waiting for? To get our groceries, right? Sometimes we may be in the doctor's office. We have to wait. But what are you waiting for? To see the doctor. Every time we're waiting in hope of something. Amen? It doesn't matter where you are. It may be in traffic. What are you waiting for? To get to your destination. So in this life, God didn't say it was going to be easy. But he did say he would give us patience. Okay? So while we're waiting, ask God for a little patience. He also said that in Isaiah the 40th chapter, verse 29, he gives strength to the weary and increases the power to the weak. So when we're weak, that's when he's strong. If you think you're strong, then you'll never know what God can do. You'll never know his power. You'll never know that while you are in traffic, you may be held up for a reason. It may be an accident right ahead of you. God knows what's best. So you must wait for your waiting period. Colossians says that, and have put on the new self, which is being renewed in knowledge, in the image of our Creator. Who is our Creator? God is our Creator. He created us. He knows the plan and the purpose for our lives. So if we're waiting, it's the reason why we are waiting. So God wants us to be patient. And sometimes he allows things to happen in order to teach us to wait. Have you thought about your waiting period yet? You may have been waiting for something a mighty long time. Hey, but are you tired yet? No, you got to run this race with patience. And you got to endure until the end. While you're running, Colossians 3 and 10 says, and have put on your new self. You got to take off that old self and put on the new self. And then you got to fix your eyes on Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. You got to run and run, because one of these old days, it's going to be all over. And you want to be in that number when he calls you on up a little higher. Oh, yes. It gets weary and it gets hard running this race. But I thank God we have a Savior we can call on. We can call on him morning, noon, and night, and all in between. We don't have to make no appointment and sit in the lobby or the doctor's office waiting on Jesus. We can call him anytime. He'll hear and answer our prayers. Oh, he's a good God, church. And when you're running this race, you may get tired, and then you may feel great. And then you may take off running real fast. And when you get like my age, you slow down. But you just keep on, you just keep on running. Because one of these old days, church, it's gonna all be over. And I'm gonna walk on up a little higher. I'm gonna see the one who I'm here, I've got to wait. I've been waiting on some things for a mighty long time. And sometimes even I get tired. And that's when you have to pray. And you have to come among brothers and sisters of the same character. You got to come in the house of the Lord to get renewed, to put on a new strength. Because God said, He is our strength. He is our refuge in times of trouble. Yes, He is. I'm so glad. When I think I can't go on, He gives me strength. Strength that I never knew I had. This morning is one of those days. Thank you, Lord, for the strength you have provided. Oh, you're such a mighty and a good God. Oh, God, I know that there's a lot of people in God's word that waited a long time. Y'all remember the lady with the issue of blood? She waited for 12 long years. Oh, I don't know if you waited that long for anything, but I know that lady got tired of waiting. My Bible says just one touch. And then I was reading and says, Lord, how many people waited? Y'all remember Abraham and Sarah, you know, waited a long year. He was 100 and she was 90 before they had their child. Yes. Amen. Yes, God. I don't know how long y'all waited, but I know I couldn't have a child that old. But they waited a mighty long time. So sometimes you gotta wait because it's in God's plan or it's in His plan. And then I thought about Zacchaeus. Oh, y'all know the little man that wanted to see Jesus. Oh, you may think that he didn't wait long, but he wanted to see Jesus. So he had to run ahead of the crowd. And he had to climb up in a tree. And he had to wait for Jesus to come by. Are you waiting for Him to come by? Huh? Are you waiting? Sometimes we have to do some things and wait for Him. Because it's not in God's timing. You know, I think it was Dottie People who wrote the song, He's an on-time God. Yes, He is. She just didn't say He was an on-time God. She said, yes, He is. He may not come when you want Him, but He's always on time. He's always on time. So don't go against God's timing, because God knows what's best. But while you're there waiting, seek Him to be you're all in all. Pray. And you may have to sing, oh, Lord, I want you to help me. Oh, yes, I sing it all the time. Oh, Lord, I want you to help me. Oh, help me on my journey. Oh, Lord, help me. On my way, singing, oh, oh, Lord, I want you to help me. Oh, yeah. While I'm praying, want you to help me. While I'm praying. you to help me. Help me on my journey. Oh, Lord, help. Oh, yes, Lord. Singing, oh, oh, Lord, I want you to help me. How many ask the Lord to help them? Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Won't he help you? Yes, he will. Oh, yes, he'll help you. I know that he will. Sometimes that's where I get my strength from, in a song. But while you're waiting, and then I'm going to sit down, I'm going to tell y'all this story that I found. Well, I hope that is true. But while I thought about it, while we're waiting and while we're on this journey, you know, we hear about the eagle. And I told Pastor this. I said, you preached this sermon, this scripture before, and you said something about what the eagles do. But I know they flop their wings. And I know they can fly real high. So, church, when you wait, you want to flop your wings, and you want to fly real high. And the other birds, and in our case, people will get intimidated. But let me tell you, it says that the only bird that would dare peck an eagle is a crow. And the crow sits on the back of the eagle, and he sits there. But the eagle just act like the crow is not there. He pecks on him, and he just let him stay on his back. And the eagle flaps his wings. He flaps his wings, and he go higher and higher and higher and higher. And old crow is still sitting on his back. And he know the eagle can't do nothing because he's on his back. He go a little higher, and he keep going higher till he gets so high the old crow can't breathe. And the old crow falls down. That's the way we ought to wait on the Lord. When things are all around us, we just wrap our hands and wave and say, Lord, I thank you. I praise you. I magnify your name. Get thee behind me, Satan, in the name of Jesus. And just knock him off, knock him off, knock him off, knock him off. Wait, wait, wait on the Lord. Just wait on the Lord. I want to tell y'all, be like the eagle. Because while you're waiting, God is taking you higher. It says what we should learn. Don't fight the crow. Don't fight the people. Just keep ascending. They may be alone for the ride, but they will soon fall off. Hallelujah. They will fall off. Do not allow yourself to be distracted by what other people say and what they do. Just wait on the Lord. And I hope I've encouraged somebody that's going through something today that think they may want to give up. Don't give up, because the race is not given to the swift or to the strong. It's to he that endureth until the end. So you hold on and you don't give up, because God got it. He's got it, amen? Doors of the church are now open. Lord Jesus. If you're here today and you don't know what you're even waiting for, I hope you're waiting on Jesus. You know, Zacchaeus, that's who he wanted to see, because he received his blessing. See, after waiting up there in that tree, Zacchaeus became saved. Because Jesus knew he was up there in that tree. So you may be here today. I'm wondering if you want to go up in the tree. I don't know what your tree may be, but go up in the tree Take a look at Jesus, what he done on that cross for you and I. You know, they hung him high, oh, and they stretched him wide. For you and me, he died. And then they took him and buried him in a borrowed tomb. But I'm so glad on that third appointed morning, he got up with all power. Yes, in his hand. All power in his hand. So today, if you want to give your life to Christ and join this family, God's family, you may come and take a seat at the front of the church. You can renew if your strength need to be renewed today. You can come and get renewed, because God is our strength. He's everything. Don't think money or anything is our strength. It's not. It's good to have money, but God, he is our strength. You may come as the choir sing. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Yeah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Jesus. 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 You can still come.
Reverend Washington and the Blackburn Chapel Church family. We have Brother Saliki Ellison. I hope that's right. He's coming for prayer for healing. He said he has a lot of things going on with him and problems with people, but he just want to be healed.
Amen. Yes. Amen. We know that God is a healer. He is the great physician. He can do anything but fail, according to our faith. So you're in the right place. You are in the right place. Jesus.
As Reverend Washington is praying, if there's anyone that wants prayer this morning, we want to ask that you would all stand for a moment, please. All over the room, we just want you to stand up. And if you want prayer, maybe you have a healing need also, and you didn't come up like our brother Ellison. But we want to invite you to come. Maybe you want to stand in the gap for somebody that needs a healing. Whatever that healing may be, whatever infraction there is, God is a healer. He's a mender. He's a mender of broken hearts. He will take that cracked vessel and he will heal it. He will heal the heart and the mind. He will make us right. He will make your path straight. God is just so good. Thank you for all those that have come. And if you want prayer and you're watching us online, we do not want to forget about you. Please just drop your name and drop these words. Please pray for me. And we will pray for you in the name of the Lord. Let us bow our heads. Father, we honor you because you are great. You are great and greatly to be praised. So, Lord, we come thanking you because we know how great you are. I pray that you will look upon those that took a step of faith this morning and that have come down to this altar, Lord. Whatever the healing might need, we pray right now together as a body of Christ that you would heal the land, that you would heal us, oh God. That you would work out, Lord, the things that we need you to work out. That you would help us, oh God, as we wait on you as the word has come today. Help us, oh God, and heal us even in our waiting, oh God. Because waiting is not easy, but we know that we can do all things through you. So help those that are here that need help in the waiting. And I pray that you would bless and heal us, Lord. Heal our hearts, heal our minds, heal our bodies, oh God. Heal the situation, oh Lord. And even those that are praying with us online, we do not forget them. And we ask that you would touch and heal in their hearts and minds also. And bring us with a testimony of the greatness and the faithfulness of a mighty, mighty good God. We thank you for this prayer right now and honor you, Lord. And with a heart of expectation, we look for our healing because you are good and your mercies endure forever. Thank you, Lord. You are good. And your mercies endure us forever. Thank you, Lord, because you are good. And your mercies endure it forever. Bless us and make us to be a blessing, oh God, in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you in Jesus' name. Can the church say praise the Lord? I just want to ask that you would just point your hands this way to Reverend Washington. Lord, we ask that you would renew and refresh the messenger this morning. We thank you for the word that you have brought, oh God. We thank you for the move of the Holy Spirit. We thank you for the encouragement to wait. We will wait. And we ask that you would refresh, Lord, our sister, our beloved sister, that you would renew her and encourage her, oh God, for being used as your vessel this morning. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Is it all right if we are subject to the Holy Ghost?
Amen.
Is it all right if we just let the Lord have his way and do what he wants us to do when he wants us to do it? I think that's a good model to live by. Bless the name of our God. I don't know that there's any other announcements. Elder Wallace, are there any announcements that you have? If there's no other announcements, we just want to ask that you would stand so we might be dismissed. In the name of the Lord, we are grateful to God for the blessing of this day. And as we go, please remember the words that have come that we should wait. That we should wait. It's not good. It's not easy, but it's always good. For those of you that are not patient. Came down my street. Lord, help me to wait. If you're like me, God is able to help even me. Bless the name of our God. Let's lift our hands without wrath or doubting. Father, we thank you for the worship today. We have enjoyed ourselves in you, and we pray that you might be pleased with the worship that we've given you, because it was from our hearts that we've given it to you. We ask that you would bless us as we go from this place. Bless our pastor and our first lady and all those that could not be here today. But we thank you, Lord, that you are here. And because you are here, Lord, we can go out without wrath or doubting. Now unto you, Lord, that's able to keep us from falling and able to present us faultless before yourself with exceeding great joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, now, henceforth, and forevermore. Let us all say amen.
If you're looking for God, you're in the spot.